A very good morning to all of you. Yesterday we had discussed about the household applications of the microbes in human welfare. Today I am going to start the industrial application of the microbes. So as clear from the name, industrial application means the microbes that are used in the industries for the various commercial processes. First one is in the industrial purposes, microbes are grown in the large vessels or the large containers where they are fermented, and these large vessels or containers are called fermenters. So microbes are grown in the large vessels, and these vessels are known as fermenters. Now why they are grown in a large vessels? They are grown in a large vessel to form the fermented beverages, antibiotics, enzymes and other bioactive molecules are prepared for the commercial purpose or for the use of the human beings. So the things that are fermented in the industrial scale are the fermented beverages, antibiotics, enzymes and bioactive molecules. These all are produced in large scale production in the industries. So yesterday I told you about the brewer's yeast, that is basically the Saccharomyces cerevisiae. So this is also called the brewer yeast. This is used to prepare wine, rum, brandy, whiskey, beer, etc. So in the fermented beverages, these things are made with the help of the brewer's yeast, that is the wine, rum, brandy, whiskey and the beer. Now how it is formed? It depends upon the process and the raw material that is used. Ab jo process hai wo kis tarah ka process hai, kitna usko heat up kara hai, kitna usme se aapne extract nikala hai, raw material aap kya use kar rahe ho. On the basis of the depending upon the raw material and the process of processing, we can obtain different types of products like wine, rum, brandy, whiskey, beer, etc. from the brewer's yeast. So if fermented broth is distilled, then the brandy and rum are produced, while wine and beer are produced without distillation. Fermented broth means the medium which is used to culture or to make some beverages. So fermented broth, jab hum usko distill karte hain, jab uski distillation karte hain, then we get the product like brandy and the rum. While wine or beer jo hai wo hum without distillation, jo bina uski separation kare, bina uski distillation kare, wo jo product hamare paas banta hai, that is wine and the beer. So the industrial applications of the microbes that they are made on the large scale, they are produced on the large scale in the industries. So large vessels are contained, yeah, you can say large vessels are used for this all process of fermentation, and these vessels are known as fermenters. Now the fermented beverages, antibiotics, enzymes and bioactive molecules are produced in the industry on the large scale. Brewer's yeast, that is also known as Saccharomyces cerevisiae, is used to make the different types of the beverages like the wine, rum, brandy, whiskey and beer. दिस ऑल इज मेड फ्रॉम द बीवर्स यीस्ट, बट द डिफरेंस इज दैट इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द रॉ मटीरियल एंड द मैथड ऑफ द प्रोसेसिंग बाई विच वी कैन गेट द डिफरेंट प्रोडक्ट्स. नाउ इफ द फर्मेंटेड ब्रॉथ इज डिस्टिल्ड वी विल गेट द ब्रांडी एंड रम, एंड वाइल इफ वी डोंट डिस्टिल द फर्मेंटेड ब्रॉथ वी विल गेट द वाइन एंड द बियर. नेक्स्ट वन इज द एंटीबायोटिक्स. हाउ माइक्रोब्स हेल्प इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द एंटीबायोटिक्स. Now certain microbes are used for the production of the antibiotics. What did these microbes basically do? These microorganisms inhibit the growth of another microorganism where they usually grow. So antibiotics are the chemical substances that are produced by the certain microbes that kill or retard the growth of the disease causing microbes. So antibiotics, these are the chemical substances that are prepared, or you can say that are produced by chemical substances produced by certain microbes to kill or retard the growth of what disease causing microbes. So antibiotics are the chemical substances that are produced by the microbes to kill the or retard the growth of the other microbes. So penicillin was the first antibiotic. Penicillin was the first antibiotic that was produced by the Alexander Fleming, and the discovery of penicillin is the by chance discovery. इसे हम by chance discovery कहते हैं because at one of the time when the Alexander Fleming, he was working on the bacteria Staphylococcus. Once Alexander Fleming was working on the bacteria Staphylococcus, and he discovered that the growth of the Staphylococcus bacteria, what it has, it seizes the cultural plate where the penicillin notatin was grown. So it seizes the growth of the penicillin notatum. This is also a bacteria. So then he observed that there is something that can inhibit the growth of the another bacteria, and later on an effective antibiotic was established by the Chain and Flory. These are the other scientists who use the theory of the Alexander Fleming to establish the antibiotics. So let's recall once again, antibiotics are the chemical substances that are produced by the certain microorganisms to inhibit the growth or to kill the growth to kill the other disease causing microorganism. Penicillin was the first antibiotic that was discovered by the Alexander Fleming. This discovery was a by chance discovery when Alexander Fleming was working on his lab on the bacteria Penicillium notatus, he observed that the Staphylococcus growth of this Staphylococcus किजिज इन द कल्चरल प्लेट्स एंड द पेंसिलिन म्यूटेटिन वॉज ग्रोन ऑन दैम. सो इट वॉज यूज एज एन इफेक्टिव एंटीबायोटिक बाय द अनदर साइंटिस्ट नेम द चेन एंड द फ्लोरे. नेक्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द केमिकल्स एंजाइम्स एंड देयर यूजेस. So microorganisms I'm making this in a tabulated form. So here we will write the microorganisms, then the substances produced. First one is the fungus Aspergillus niger. Substance produced by this fungus is the citric acid. The second thing was a bacterium Acetobacter acetae. Bacterium, this is another microorganism. Acetobacter acetae. And this produces the acetic acid. Third one is the bacterium Clostridium butyllicium. Bacterium Clostridium it produces butyric acid. Next one is the yeast that is the ethanol that produces the ethanol. I'm writing fifth one here. Fifth one is the bacterium Lactobacillus. It produces the lactic acid. We did it yesterday in the formation of curd from the milk. Then is bacterium Streptococcus. This produces the streptokinase. Streptokinase is a clot buster for removing the clots from the blood vessels of the patient with the heart problems. Next one is fungus Trichoderma polysporum. This produces cyclosporin A, and this cyclosporin A is used as immune suppressive agent in the organ transplantation. Sorry, and the last one is the yeast Monascus, and it is and the substance is statins, and this is used in lower down the blood cholesterol levels. This is all about the today's topic about the industrial application, antibiotics and the microorganisms and the various substances produced by them. That's all, students. Thank you and have a nice day.